Hello all, this is Komli from BVC Engineering College, Odalrevu. Today our topic is clippers. Let me tell you about the definition of clipper. Clipper is a circuit which will slice some part from the waveform. That means which will remove the undesired part and it will transmit only the desired part. This will be the definition, and we can call the clipper as voltage or current limiter or amplitude selector or slicer. Clippers is of two types, single level clippers and two level clippers. We have three methods to design a clipper, that is one diode, one resistor and one reference level. The second combination is two diodes, one resistor and reference levels, and third one is transistors and resistors. By using these three combinations, we can design clippers. In the previous lecture I discussed about all these things. Now I have to discuss about single level clippers. In single level clippers, we have six types of clippers, clipping processes. One is positive clipping, negative peak clipping, negative peak above reference, negative peak below reference, positive peak above reference and positive peak below reference. And we have two types of single level clippers over there. One is series clipper and the second one is shunt clipper. So now I will explain the series clipper and the design of these six clippers by using a series diode. First one is positive peak clipping. So I will explain this in the operation in a simple way. So first one, we have to give as input, that is this one is our input. What will be the required output in the second one? Positive peak clipping means we have only the negative peak at the output. So this will be our desired output and this will be our input. So this circuit will be designed by transfer characteristics, but I will explain it in reverse direction. That means from output, how to design our clipper. So that will be the simple method to understand the design of clipper. So we know that one thing, that is whenever we have a diode, then we supply an input like this, we got positive peak only. So we have a diode like this, then we got negative peak only. So we require negative peak. For that reason we have to take the diode direction like this. So in this design of this clipper, we have an input port. At the input port we have a diode and we have an output port also. So this is our input. It will be represented as VI, and we have a resistor here. A resistor can be represented as R. We are taking output here, V naught of T. Okay, so we have to set the direction for the diode. So we require negative. So whenever positive peak occurs, the diode will be in reverse direction. So we have to connect cathode of the diode. So this is cathode and this is anode and this is diode. So see, whenever positive peak occurs, the diode will be in off state. Off state means no output. So whenever negative peak occurs, the diode is in forward biased state. That means that it is in short circuit condition. So what will be the input we are supplying, that will be present at output. So we have to write our condition. This was the third point, and the fourth point is condition that whenever VI greater than or equal to zero, that means positive value, the diode is in off state. the diode is in off state. By that way, the output will be 0. And Vi less than 0, the diode will be in on. Now, the output will be input. Okay, right. So, I'll draw the transfer characteristics. This will be the fifth point. So, it is 0. And this is Vi. We are taking output here V naught. So, whenever positive values occur, the V naught will be 0. Whenever negative values will occur, V naught will be equal to Vi. So, this will be our transfer characteristics. Draw our input here. So, where the DC level will occur, that portion will clip out. So, we have only this part as output. So, this is the way how we get an output. So, but in a simple format, I will explain from the output the design. So, this is the simple way to design a clamper. Sorry, clipper. Let's see second one. Negative peak clipping. Negative peak clipper. So, negative peak clipper. We have same input. And the required output is negative peak, means positive peak will be there. So, at the input port, we want a diode. So, the direction of the diode has to decide. So, whenever diode will be connected in this direction, we have positive peak. No? So, that diode will be connected like this. So, we have a resistor here. So, we get output from across R. So, this is anode and this is cathode. Whenever positive peak occurs, the diode will be in, that is Vi greater than 0. The diode will be in forward biased condition, on state. The output will be equal to Vi. So, Vi less than or equal to 0, that is diode is in off state. Whenever negative peak occur, the diode will be in reverse biased condition. So, output will be equal to 0. So, this is Vi and V naught 0. So, it is positive value. V naught will be equal to Vi. So, for negative values, this will be 0. So, this is our input. And DC line occur here, no? So, this part will clip. And this part will be there in the output. This is the way how to design a negative peak clipper. And the third one, positive peak above reference. So, this is our input and this is our output. So, at the input, we have to connect a diode. The direction of diode should be like this. Why? Because whenever negative peak occur, it should be in short circuit. So, we have Vi. So, in series with the resistor, we have to connect our reference voltage Vr. So, for Vr, up to Vr, if Vi greater than Vr, up to then, the diode should be in on in state. Then only the input will transmit it to output. So, it should be connected positive. Why? Because when positive is connected here, this will be in forward condition, forward biased condition. So, this is V naught and this is Vr. So, the condition should be like this. If Vi greater than or equal to Vr and Vi less than Vr. For Vi greater than or equal to Vr means that Vi has, for example, plus 7. It is of plus 5. It is fixed, no? So, both, when compare both, so which has plus 7 has maximum positivity, so it will consider as positive and it will be considered as negative. Positive will be connected to cathode, and this will be acts as, the diode will be acts as off switch. It is in reverse bias then. So it is an off, that is, it is open circuited. Then what will be the output? Output will be zero. So whenever we are supplying lesser amount of voltage compared to VR, so for example it is +2 +5, so compare these two, which has maximum positivity +5, so it is considered as negative. So negative will be connected to cathode, the diode will be in on state, V naught will be equal to VI. So let's see our transfer characteristics, that is VI and V naught. That is zero. We are taking a positive reference there. So we are representing VR here and VR. So for VR, VI greater than VR condition, the output will be equal to, sorry, VR. So whenever it will act as open circuit across this shunt line, what will be the output? It will be equal to VR. Sorry. So VR. So diode is an off, so for this we have VR. So VI less than conditions, less than means these values, the value of output will be equal to input. We got a nomic line, so write our drawer input. So this up to here we got a DC line, so this portion will clipped out, only this part will be there in the output. So this is the way how to design our positive peak clipper above reference level. Next, positive peak below reference level. So this is our input again, and output will be below reference, means all this part will clipped out. So in the design we have a positive peak, no? So the direction of diode will be like this. Whenever positive peak will occur, the diode will be in forward condition. So now see the direction of VR. VR should be connected like this. Why? Because if VI greater than VR condition, then the diode should be in reverse bias, then only we are not getting any output. So negative should be connected to, that means cathode should be connected to positive, then only it should be in reverse biased condition. So positive, negative, it is VR, anode, cathode, diode. This is our input and this is our output. So let's see whether it works or not. If VI greater than or equal to VR, what will be the diode direction? So VI greater than VR, again +7 +5, so +7 would be considered as positive, negative, and that it is in forward biased condition, no? So diode is in on. If diode is in on, what will be the output? It will be equal to input. So if we consider +2, this will be considered as negative and this will be considered as positive, then the diode for this condition, diode will be in off state. If it is in off, we have only this shunt line, so V naught will be equal to VR. Now let's see the transfer characteristics. We have zero, VR here, VR, this is output and this is input. So up to here the value of greater values V not equal to VI, for lesser values it will be equal to VR. So draw our input, and we have DC line here, no? So this will be clipped part and this will be there in the output. This is the design of positive peak clipper below reference level. And the fifth one is negative peak clipper above reference level, and this will be our input and this will be our output. Negative peak clipper above reference level. This part, total part will clipped. So we have a negative portion here. So negative cathode will be connected here. Up to here, we have to set the diode to reverse bias. So we have to connect the negative polarity of VR to the anode of diode. This will be our input and this will be our output. So let's see the condition. If VI less than VR, that means let it be, it is minus 5 and it is minus 7. VI greater than VR. Okay. So output V naught, let's see. So it will be considered as, the diode will be considered as on. Why? Because it has maximum negativity. So it will be considered as on. So it will be equal to VI. So if VI greater or equal to greater values, that means VI greater values means minus 2. It will be considered positive and it will be considered as negative. So it is an off state. So output will be equal to minus VR. Why? Because we are changing the direction of VR, no? So we got the condition like this. So it is 0 V naught VI and this is minus VR. So we have minus VR, no? So minus VR. So for greater values of minus VR, for greater values we have, it is minus VR. So it, up to here we have a DC line. After that V naught will be equal to VI. So now draw our input here. So the DC line part will be clipped out. So only this part will be there in the output. This is the way how to design a negative P clipper above reference level. Let's see the sixth one. Negative peak clipper below reference level, and this is our input and this is our output. Negative peak below, this part will clipped. So we have the positive peak here. So we have to connect the diode in this direction, anode and cathode, and we are representing diode as D. We are supplying input, and up to VR, the diode should be in forward biased condition. So cathode is there, na? So we have to connect negative peak. So it is VR. This is our output. So let's see the condition. So if VI less than VR, VI greater than minus VR, sorry, minus, we have to put minus there. For greater values of minus VR, greater values of minus VR, so the diode should be in on state. It should be in on. Why? Because it is minus 5, it is minus 2. This will be considered as positive, this is considered as positive. Diode will be in on. So V naught will be equal to VI. For VI less than minus VR condition, that is it is minus 7, so it will be considered as negative. So negative will be connected to anode, this will be in off state. V naught will be equal to the shunt line voltage, that is minus VR. So let's see the transfer characteristics. So this is 0 and this is minus VR and this is minus VR, VI, and we have V naught here. So up to minus VR, greater values, we have the diode as an on state. So we got this line. So after that, for lesser values, it will be in off. V naught will be equal to VR. So now draw our input here. So the DC line will be here. So this portion will be there in the output. By that way, we can design the clipper negative peak below reference level. This is the way how to design all the series clippers. Hope you understand about this. In the next lecture, I will explain about the shunt clippers, all shunt clippers. Thank you.